It makes me feel good about myself because I know I helped the team get to where it is now these past couple years. My sophomore year, I did a little bit but didn't do much, but it feels good to show I'm improving on and off the field and helping this team grow as a team and it gets better in the future. I mean, yeah, we're cool. We know they're a good team. We know we're a good team. We always have a game plan for every team, nothing new. Keep the same game plan. I mean, just play our game that we usually play and hopefully we come out with a W. Oh, no.
No.
Usually we just drive. They like the big trucks, you know. Everybody really? Likes the big trucks over here.
Over here in Chesterfield, yeah. Central Corridor?
Everybody wants to be a hillbilly, redneck. We're all in. Hey, everybody has to buy into the program, buy into what the coaches are selling, basically, and just push forward and just have a hell of a year. I say Park Point North was a nice game for me.
Really?
Even though we lost, I mean, it was a hell of a game.
Yeah.
But I feel like I put my team in positions to make plays. We shot ourselves in the foot that game, mm-hmm. and we just didn't execute. But I had a couple nice games. Rockwood, my first game, Rockwood Summit, I had a nice 160 yards that game total. And then my Melville game was a big one. I had 3 touchdowns. Most likely running. But it feels good for me to put points on the board for my team. But it all goes to the offensive line. They helped me get in the end zone, basically. And the two guys in the backfield with me, Jordan Robertson and Wendell Bonner, they're a big help. When I'm tired, need a breather, they come in and still do the workhorse for me. Oh, just the feeling in the weight room. Right before the game, we get hype. We get our future going. Got everybody in the jumping, dabbing, all that good stuff. You know, we turn it up. Oh, that he's hard on us. We need a coach that's going to be on us all the time, pushing us to get better and better. Never letting us slack on and off the field. He's always checking us up on the class. All of our coaches are. But we just have a good coaching staff overall. They're always on us, trying to push us to be better people overall.
Has that kind of been one of the huge differences from the past couple of years up until now?
Yes, I would say it has been. He's built a culture for Marquette that hasn't been here for the past couple of years, the old culture set. And it's just been growing, as you can see. It's making improvement year by year. Yeah, my freshman year, I was all over the place. I missed a whole period one time. It was crazy. Yeah. This school is really big. You don't know. They got like a foreign language section and all that. Social studies section is crazy. I mean, yeah, but also not, because I'm just not one person on the field. It's 11 people on the field helping you do the work.
Right.
And I mean, it feels good inside just to make me feel like I've accomplished something, but I also got to give it to the other 10 men that's on the field with me, working hard just as I am. Oh, the beginning, when we break it out. Definitely Avengers. I'm going with Avengers.
Oh, God, okay. I like Star Wars. Well,
I can tell.
Yeah.
Definitely Madden. I play Madden every night. History. Danny Family.
And who's the artist?
Future. Probably a knife. That's a tough one. I'm gonna give it to Randy Moss. He makes plays. Randy Moss made plays when he was in there.
So old Jerry Rice made plays.
not as big as Randy Moss. I mean, Randy Moss made some crazy plays when he was there. And for the Vikings, he was like, I want to say Odell pretty bad, but I mean, he's too early. It's too early for him to be, yeah. And he just got shut down a couple weeks ago. Friday Night Lights.
No, it's two. This is a little more up your alley here. So, true or false, Marquette, in these last 2 years that you guys have won 16 games, the last 4 years before these two seasons, you have won 15 games. True or false?
That's true.
That is true. Yes, correct. All right. So, the Cubs are in the World Series now, and here's a... You don't like that?
No.
Okay, good. Well, Dylan Conway, I know he's celebrating because he hates the Cardinals.
That's my boy. Shout out to Dylan.
He hates the Cardinals, so I guess he loves the Cubs. So, true or false, the Ottoman Empire was around the last time the Cubs won the World Series in 1908.
True.
That is true, yes.
Oh, me and my boy, Jordan, our Wendell, we come out, give our handshake. Go ahead, flick it. You already know. For the fans.